really hope that we do well. I'm looking forward to all of the competitions, and I really hope that everybody puts their all into their practices and rehearsals. I think our greatest strength is like the community that we have and the connections we form with each other. It really allows us to like help each other and grow as like a whole band. Like whenever anyone needs help, no one will be afraid to like just ask for it and become better, like as a person and a musician.
My name is Justin Cole. My position is battery technician. I had my first private lesson when I was 5 years old. So probably then. It depends on what you count as starting. I was nervous at first. As we get into more of a routine, I feel like I'm starting to get more of the hang of it. And it helps that all the students are very enthusiastic and cooperative and want to be here and want to learn. In 1 year, I see the band as being more in the spotlight of the entire school. I see more members, more confident veterans, and better playing than probably some of us are used to. I think there's a lot of different angles you can view that situation from. There have been plenty of setbacks, I'm sure. You can see them as potentially breaking an organization, or you can see them as hurdles to get over. And I think the fact that after all those hurdles, all these returners want to be here and are trusting that it will get better is a promising sign.
Dude, I'm trying to take a video! Alright, I'm Lauren Riley and I have the head drummer at WBC. I'm expecting a lot of productivity, but also a lot of learning. This is a lot of freshmen. I think we have a lot of traditions that we keep close, and I really appreciate it. I'm excited for the season.
Hi, my name's James. I'm an assistant drum major at Granada Strawn High School. I just hope that the season goes really well. We end off the season with a bang for all the seniors out there. Definitely a lot of support. We have a lot of parent support, faculty support, teacher support. And we have a great group of students here, especially our newcomers. I can tell that they're all really excited to, you know, just get the season going. But for sure, we are going to do well. I know that we will.
Nicole Naharo, and I'm a color guard captain. I think it's going to be a good season. A good communication and like bond throughout everyone.
I'm Abigail, and I'm color guard captain. I think our show's going to look really good. It's
going to
be good.
Definitely, like Nicole said, like a good bond. I think everyone is like friendly with each other, so.
I'm having a lot of fun so far. I'm excited that we got candy, and I'm excited to play instruments later. I'm hoping for the best this season. We're gonna win this season. Really good instructors, and just like that, the passion for it. Renato's got that passion.
I'm hated. What instrument? I want to play quads. My expectations is that everyone will learn the music, because we got a pretty good show coming up, and we will not fail. We'll get A tier. We'll beat Chino Hills with their show. What do you think we are? I think we got a lot more coaches, especially since last year we only had one percussion coach, well, battery coach, and we now have wind coaches for like woodwinds and brass. I will help a lot.
I'm Shane. To do my best at playing the bass drum, I'm gonna be in percussion. Yeah. We have stricter rules here, like you can't use your phone, probably unlike other LAUSD schools. Yeah, I hope it. I've heard that last season was like really bad. But I just hope it. I hope we do well this season.
I wish we could just get right into it.
Hi, my name is Juan Gonzalez, and I am the color guard director here for the Granada Hills Charter Color Guard and Marching Band Program. I've been teaching here since the fall of 1999, right after I graduated from high school, as a technician all the way through 2007, and then moved on and became the director for the color guard starting in the fall of 2008. And I have been here since. I've been teaching color guard for the past, well, since 1999, and I've been teaching it all over the country, Arizona, Nevada, Maryland, California, of course, teaching at every level, middle school, high school, drum corps, independent winter guard, drum corps, and I also judge winter guard in the fall marching band seasons. One of the things that I've always noticed here is that the way that the students are and the way the ambiance and environment that the students create along with the staff, it's actually something that always makes me want to come back. And the students' hard work and ethic really actually changes the dynamics here in a very positive way. And this is why one of the big reasons why I'm still here.
I am Mr. Cooper. I'm the director of bands. We are going to play musically. We are going to have fun. And we are going to kick some butt. It's definitely a family here. Granada is a very unique school, and students here are definitely part of a family, and it's really great to be a part of a place that is so united and wants to work together. Growing. I would say taking care of everybody else, not just worrying about your own needs, but making sure that all the needs of the people around you are also met. I am very excited. We are growing every single day, and we are well ahead of the game compared to last year, and I am just very excited. We are right where we need to be right now.
We have an actual audience. We have like 160 people coming, and everyone's been really productive and great, so I think it's pretty good.
Great. Just remember, have fun. It's all about having fun, playing well, performing. gallery for people that want to see it perform and make everyone happy. So, five or so minutes, it's almost 7:30. I want to see the drummers come in, and we'll get going.
All right. I am Evan Illich. I am the student teacher here at Granada Hills Charter. I not only help out with the marching band, but I help out with the other ensembles here at Granada Hills.
Okay, here we go. We're going to start with, just let me hear an F, get our sound going, talk through that. Mezzo forte, big full breath. One, two, F,
and. So mostly with the marching band, I help out with the winds and the visual aspect of everything. This is my first year. I have been doing marching band since 2013. I did 4 years of high school, and then I did gold drum and bugle corps back in 2016. And then I spent some time with the Mandarins, and then with the Boston Crusaders, as well as pulse percussion. I see a big sense of camaraderie amongst all the sections. That's kind of unique to other programs. Like other programs are kind of unique to this program. Other programs kind of have like their little clicks in each section, but here, like, there's a full band camaraderie that I think is special. I'm really looking forward to the season. I'm just glad we're back doing the thing in like full power after coming off of not having band for like 2 years. So it's looking great. The vibes are good. I'm really looking forward to the first show. Band's sounding great. We're looking great. We're working hard. So.
I'm one of the front ensemble techs here at Granada Hills Charter High School. Here specifically, just a couple years, but I've been teaching since I went here at Nobel and various other high schools in the valley. I do. I miss playing mallets, but my hands couldn't keep up with me. They still crack. But I really loved playing synth. I would say that there's a really, really strong family culture here. And I think every group says that, but I think it's truly true for this one. There's been a lot of change over the last couple years, but the main thing that's stayed consistent is just the drive from the students and the membership to just kind of keep the heart of it going, even if traditions are lost. It's interesting because I've gotten to see the group evolve and adapt and change and digress in some ways and get better in others. But overall, it's for the most part the same group fundamentally because of the members. A constant that I've seen at Granada, and honestly happened while I was here, so kind of take the blame for that, is that we tend to plateau right before the end of the season and get disappointed at the very end because we don't push. So I think that would be the thing that's the most constant about Granada that maybe should change. Oh gosh. I think part of it has to come from the staff side. And since there's been so much change, it's like, it's kind of on us to keep you guys motivated. So I'm gonna try and keep you motivated. Great question. If you have the right mindset, playing for the ensemble is playing for yourself. But I would say to the kind of the purpose of the question, playing for yourself is kind of like reaching your own personal goals and like achieving your own bests, but playing for an ensemble is not just doing things for yourself, but giving parts of yourself to everyone else, giving your time, giving like some stress, some blood, sweat, and tears, and just like putting your all in the field. It's risk, you know? You don't know if you're all gonna do well. You don't know if someone else is gonna be responsible for your failure or if you're gonna be responsible for your success. Like, whatever happens, it happens all together. And that's a cool hype going up to the band room. It's cute. Anyway, I feel like that's playing for the ensemble. A little bit playing for yourself, but overall, playing for the ensemble. That's a good hype.
We'll be right back. Hey, Captain.
My favorite part about band. This is a hard question. I've been doing this for like 4 years now. I probably say it's the community, the people, especially the ones who hit. It's like we've become kind of like a family over the years. And though we have people graduate, it's like there's new family members brought in, like Hayden. He's not in Pitt, but we love him. We treat him like family. And I just love that aspect of band, and that's what keeps me coming back. So I actually started on Bells, but then I got moved to Vibe because somebody quit. But seeing my progress is insane because I went from like kind of like the outer Vibe, like the one that wasn't really like the most skilled, to like having a lot more experience and just like more experience in general, and like knowledge on music, and just like even knowledge about like leading and everything. And it's just crazy to see the comparison between now and then, because it's like exponential. I think what separates our band from other bands is, I don't know, I feel like the connections that we all have, because like, sure, we do go to rehearsals, but like in between it, like the main reason that sometimes we do slack off is because we enjoy each other's company so much that we just want to like use it as like time to like be friends with one another and just like play around. At the same time, we do focus and we do flip that switch when we need to, and I just feel like not many other bands have that like specific like connection that brings everyone together. Like people willingly plan like hangouts for band related, unlike many other bands. So I think that's what separates us. We have to load up, so we're about to start our first last halftime performance of my senior year.
It's almost halftime and we are about to perform our fight song for the standard. We are doing very good.
I'm Azul. I am a drum set player for Front Ensemble.
I mainly like the community aspect, like all the people are really nice. Of course I enjoy playing too, but just the people are the best part of it. I've been playing since 7th grade in middle school, and I'm in 11th grade now. It's taught me to be more like responsible with my like work ethic. It's also just probably just made me a better person overall.
Yo, what's up?
You have it?
It's raining again.
Here we go, letter B, all the way to the release at the end of the first impact. Breakdown of that chunk, it's hold 24, move 12, move 18, hold 12, hold 12, move 6, hold 24, plus 1. Here we go. Set.
B's at the end of the impact.
B's at the end of the impact.
am so excited. I can't wait to perform. My name is Alex and I am base four. Hell yeah. Well, yeah, we will. Kilt personality. We have a very slay, woodwind section, a very slay brass section, a very slay guard, very slay percussion. Everyone, including most of our, all of our attacks are very, they're very slay. I love them all. One more thing to say, I am very proud of the entire band because like we put so much effort into our practices. I know it's been like difficult and everything, but like during our first comp, we're gonna prove that all that time was worth it.
It's our first comp. I think we're prepared. Yeah, I think we're gonna get more prepared during rehearsal, but I think generally we're pretty ready because we have worked very hard, and I see the amount of effort that these students put into this program, and I think we've made really good progress, and I'm really proud of everyone. And good luck.
Show, and it's special because we are going to nail it tonight because we spent so much time and we're just ready to do this and show everybody what we can do. This is our only our only SESPOA show, just to get us a start before we head into the big leagues with our WBA shows. It's good to get one to, out of the way. This is not really a throwaway show, but it's definitely a great opportunity for us to get a performance in front of a competitive crowd under our feet before we travel up and down the state to do these other shows. Let's go kick some butt.
I'm Chris Knott. I'm one of the crowd ensemble instructors at Granada Hills Charter High School for the 2022 to 2023 school year. This is my second year teaching here currently. I went to West Ranch High School, graduated class of 2019, then I marched RCC 2020, BD 2020, quote unquote, and then I've just been doing those groups since then. I think that like the students here are very motivated to like getting better and like very like really very willing to learn and also very inclusive in terms of being like having a good vibe and keeping a family environment. I see that effort from the members, so like that's something I really appreciate and something that I wouldn't expect to see in other programs. I'm excited for the show today. I think everyone seems like we're in a good mood. I think we still have like almost 25 minutes before we start our lot, and everyone's already set up, so everyone's sitting around having a good time. I hope that we can flip the switch and be focused once we get started. I'm sure we will.
Well, hello, my name is Neil Cole, and I'm the woodwind caption head. This is my first year at Granada. I start around Women's Band Camp, July, so and I'm excited to be here. Okay, well, one, the students are really smart. I like being in a school where the students can pick up things really fast, and so it allows us to really go to the next level even faster. Well, the first thing, I think the students are really great socially. I find that everyone loves to be here, and perhaps maybe COVID allowed us to appreciate the arts and just the social aspect of band as well, a lot more than people did before. I spent 10 years in marching band. I started in the eighth grade down in Georgia in a HBCU-based band. And then I joined the Georgia State Sound of Downtown Panther Band my first year of college. I spent 4.5 years in college, so 5 years of marching band there. And I also worked for TV and movies, doing background band for some shows like The Quad, as well as Love, Simon. And then some commercial stuff as well. The overall level of intelligence that we have here, I find that the administration is starting to find an even bigger appreciation of arts. I know we've got $100,000 worth of instruments. We have a great endowment that allows us to have magnificent staff outside of myself. I also think that the students are really involved and invested in the program.
I got you. Being prop captain is the biggest pain in my ass. Yeah, it's gonna be epic. We're gonna slay, you know, like some, like a couple of girl bosses. It's gonna be great. We're gonna simple slay.
I'm very excited to perform. I cannot wait to see the judges like literally talking in front of me. It's just, he's terrifying.
Hell yeah, we better win. Yeah, I think we have a pretty good chance of like winning, since the last time we performed it wasn't great, but we still did pretty well. So I think we have a pretty good chance.
If something runs me over, it's your fault. What's my name and instrument? I'm Franco Angelo Lim, and I play snare. It's pretty alright. I'm not really excited, but I mean, it's more interesting than what I have to do in school. Probably a little better than what we did last time. I mean, it's probably more than what we did earlier.
It's scary. Don't tell the rest of the band, though. It's a secret.
I think no matter what our score is, we did good.
If we get less than an 80, I'm gonna be sad. My date is banking on an 80.
Your date?
My date is banking on an 80.
I think we need more practice. In the second half of part three, it'll be a lot better.
It was a poor decision to do movement three after 1 week or 2 weeks.
Fine. I don't know. We could have done better. I heard that props were missing and stuff, and the wind affected the.
Yeah. There was no prop safe from the wind.
Also winning the Captain Awards for Best Percussion, Best Color Guard. Granada Hills Club.
We just won high percussion at the second comp of the season. It was our first WBA comp, competing in 3A at El Camino College. Feels pretty good. I think I have a tendency to be hard on myself as an instructor, and sometimes slightly hard on the kids, and I think the students also have a tendency to be a little bit hard on themselves. So I hope this was rewarding for them, and it'll provide them with some real good hard evidence that they can play well. We were, the staff and I, it was me, Cooper, Jazz, Evan, and Jenny. We were all just standing on the end of the field near hospitality. We were standing by the end of the field near hospitality, and we were all just standing in a line, like, gripping our hands and, like, listening to each of the bands go by, and I was like, okay, we didn't get fifth, we didn't get last. All right, we didn't get fourth, we medaled. We didn't get third, that's awesome! And they announced a second, and then they mentioned high percussion and high guard, and I was like, who is that? That could be us. And then they announced it was us, and Jazz and I just turned to each other and screamed and jumped and didn't know what to do. It was great. No. Honestly, no. Bye, Neil. You can cut that out. Or not. It was not what I expected. I don't know. I think I have a tendency to just be hard on myself, and I was like, oh, that was clean. I was listening to the show, like, that was clean. That wasn't. We can do that better. And I was listening to the judge tape, like, okay, we got a lot of feedback on things we can improve on. And I started getting it going in my head, like, okay, we might have gotten third, maybe fourth. Definitely didn't win high percussion. And I was glad to be proven wrong. Great job to the percussion section. Very proud of you. And go Highlanders.
For 1,000 years!
Yeah!
The Highlanders have marched into pride and to battle with pride and honor. Through hard work and strife, we persevere, attempting to become better than the day before. Though we may falter, we never give in. We push forward without regard. We must know that our actions matter. But for the sake of ourselves!
Yeah!
Win, lose, rain, or shine! We are family!
I think we made our mark, and the judges were very receptive to our growth. And I think we made a strong impression our first time out. Pretty awesome. And I'm excited for our big regional in Mission Viejo in a couple weeks. And that'll be a big test and a lot more big bands to check out. We just gotta keep working. Gotta finish the show and gotta add a bunch of stuff and gotta make things better.
Hi, my name is Cesar Avina. I work with the Granada Hills Chartered Color Guard. I've been here for roughly just this past season. Previously, I marched for indoor groups of Infinity Wonder Guard and Diamante Wonder Guard. I march at Icon currently. For outdoor, I march Phantom Regiment and Blue Coats. So the unique thing about here, well, one fun thing about here is that it is your own first, which is oddly a big thing because now you shove in 2 hours of rehearsal. And I think we're pretty good at not like letting it like be a downer because obviously it's in the morning, so that's always a good thing. So now we're always kind of pushing forward, and it does allow us to just have one night rehearsal, which makes it so like the morale doesn't die just by shoving in a bunch of rehearsals every day. So it is nice that we do have that morning time. We get a bunch of things done and we're efficient about it, and then you go on with your day. Right now, even this is a smaller band, which it really isn't, right? From there you bring your friends, you keep going, you climb, it just gets bigger and better and more fun. You get to do more fun, exciting things. Yeah, I mean, the only thing that's stopping us is just numbers. I shouldn't say that, but you know, like numbers is very important, right? To even reach 5A and persistence. It's all a mental game. We're all doing the same thing. We're all just a bunch of high school kids, you know, doing marching band in the morning and the afternoon. There's nothing different that separates from us. The only difference is that they think they're great and we think they're great. You know what I mean? So we just need to bring that into ourselves, think that we're great, and we'll soon be there with them.
Oh, this week is the second to last week of our field season, and it's rainy, so it's gonna be really difficult to finish out the show. You know, I can't say for certain. I was surprised by our scores at the first WBA competition. So judging by what happened last week, or last other week, I think we have a chance. We definitely do.
This week is really special because
This is where all of the changes in our show becomes permanent, and it also decides our skill cap, our like skill ceiling and our skill floor. We also don't have a lot of comps left, so I think this is the time to cherish like the line that we're with and who we're performing with. It depends who we're competing against. If it's the same competition as last week, which was the WBA Super Show, I think we can definitely hit first place because percussion and color guard got first place in all of 3A. And all of us felt like it was a relatively bad rep. So if we can hit our skill ceiling, then I definitely think we can hit first place. But I'm gonna be honest, last year I was a hella crazy kid. I had no supervision at all, and like it was just so crazy. After joining Winterline as a Tom or Flubs, I learned a lot of etiquette for rehearsal, and I feel like I like building a lot of discipline with my section. And now that we've been practicing that, we have so much more discipline as a percussion section, and that basically we're the most disciplined section in the whole band.
Because my job is to fix all of the things that are not great. But right now, you are looking and sounding like a band that wants to make finals next Sunday. You have to keep up that momentum. We are not done. You've got to keep doing exactly what you're doing and get better every single day. Then get a quick sip and reset, St. John. Quick sip and reset.
Comp number 3, regionals. I'm gonna win. That's our best.
Today is the regional championships for WBA. It is our third competition and our second to last weekend. I think we're doing pretty good. I'm a little nervous because it's our first time to put like all three movements together and performing it. So it's a little nerve-wracking, but I'm cool with it.
What's today? I know it's regionals, isn't it? Nice pop quiz. Well, everyone always like thinks we'll do poorly, and then we top it out at like second at least. So I believe in everyone. Yeah, I'm a little nervous about part 3. Why? Because we've been doing well so far and everyone's really good, especially percussion. And guard. Yeah, there you go. Let's get some percussion.
My name is Morgan. I'm in percussion and I'm a synth player. Today is our regional competition thing for WBA. I think we'll do okay. I mean, I don't know. Because a lot of people are not here. Okay, I think myself I'll just make a few mistakes here and there, but Brendan he still hasn't memorized his part yet a lot, and I don't know about Anthony, so yeah, I'm quite worried about that. I will sound very off key, but that's up to Brendan, not me, unfortunately. Okay, concerning skill, be Brendan, but like concerning worst ethic, I think no one has a first place.
Oh, this is not a football logo.
And both of them combined.
Yeah, we were live at Bad Lingley, and he said we better win. So, we're gonna win.
My name is Maya, and when you mean position, do you mean what instrument I play? Alto sax. Move, Anthony! Since sixth grade, and I'm in ninth, 3 years. It's fun, and I have a lot of friends in it. Today's special, because we were on the bus, and we joined Bad Ling Ling on live, and he said we're gonna win. So that's very special. And it's our third comp.
Boom!
We're about to perform, and I also am about to lose my marbles because I'm starving.
Sorry.
That's what's happening.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. Take a video of the sunset.
We're either gonna about to get rolled, or it's gonna be great.
Two WBA 3A Regional Championships.
What about test dancing? Okay, speaking. Hi, I'm Daniel Alfaro, and I'm the assistant band director. I also teach the piano and the guitar. Todd Simon, I used to play with him, and he called me. He said, hey, because I actually applied last year, and then they gave the job to Dr. Kubi, and then when she had to leave, he said, hey, are you still interested? And I said, yeah. It's a great school, it's a great music program, and it's a great band program, because I think that the kids have a lot of passion for, you know, doing a good job and making a good sound. I feel like they really, you know, have a lot of camaraderie with each other, which is fun, and there's a lot of professionalism, and there's a lot of cutting up and having fun and stuff like that. So it's a nice mix, and I know where I can kind of help get everybody moving towards the right direction. I think we'll just get more and more serious, you know? It's like being able to be confident in ourselves as players, but at the same time, humble enough to know, like, we always can get better, you know? If we get that attitude down, I think we'll be awesome. Happy to be here. I hope to continue helping out, and I really love seeing all the kids' progress. So it's been fun.
We have to be efficient tonight. We don't have a lot of time to cover all three sections before people start showing up. So we do need to move quickly and efficiently and do reps as few times as possible. Just like this morning, but even quicker and even better. Go ahead and relax.
I know we can do this. We have a lot of potential. I can see it in you guys. I can see that you guys want to succeed. You have to push yourself to get to where you want to be. I want to win. I want us to get a good score and a good rating. Can you help me do that?
Yes!
Thank you.
How many of you guys are in burnout right now? Raise your hand and be honest about it. Me too. As you can see, me, Lauren, and Sebastian are in burnout. Now keep your hand up if you want to make championships and you want to win championships. That should be all of you guys right now. So let's get our mindset right. Let's treat these next 2 days right. Let's all come prepared. And let's do this.
He said, no! He said to push yourself, but also push each other. You guys are teammates in the end, and you're supposed to help each other out. We do not sound like we do because of our individuality. It's as a group. So we gotta help each other as a group to stay focused. If you see your friend or your bandmate not focused, get them focused. We barely have any more time, and it's about damn time we make it a champ. Yeah! Yeah!
What are you looking at?
I love the band here. They're so determined and ambitious, almost to a fault, but they really do believe that they can be really good, and they're willing to work hard for it. That's really all we can ask when it comes to the things we can't teach them, right? I can teach my students notes and rhythms and visuals, but I can't teach them to want to do it right. I can't teach them to want to win, but you guys have that. Granada has that. It's incredible and really enjoyable to work with. Maybe this is part of the academic rigor of the rest of the school, like the normal class curriculum, but you know, that it's that extra edge of determination. They're willing to wake up super early on top of their 5 APs to be in this band. For me, this band, it was different from my high school experience, as they're more open with each other. They will like tell their friends how much they care about them, which I think is super cool. They lift each other up, and they just want to be really good at band. Yeah, and also there's a really inclusive environment. Maybe that might just be a generational thing on my end, but everyone's open and accepting of others, and they don't put each other down for stupid reasons. So I think that's incredible, and I enjoy seeing that here. For me, it comes down to the kids just want to be here. The students, I don't have to like pull teeth to get them to want to learn. And I know a lot of teaching is like that. So props and huge respect to all the teachers out there who are teaching kids who just don't want to be there, because that's really hard and honestly something I can't do. So that's what I like about this job, is that everyone wants to be here, everyone wants to work hard, and it results in some pretty amazing stuff. Loved it. Honestly, we've been telling them all season, get hyped, don't hype too much that it ruins your music. And I could see that. I could see the the students, they were engaged. They were dedicated and committed to their show and to each other. And I could see that on the field. For my section, the symbol section, there was one thing that we've been struggling with all season, and they got it right 100% on the field, and I almost cried. Well, I did cry. But I was just so excited for them, for all the work they put in this year. So yeah, I loved that last run.
I thought everything coming in here went really smoothly, and the performance was very controlled, and now I just wait. I feel good. I think we did a lot of really hard work this year, things that will pay off in next season. We've got a lot of hard work to do coming up in content man season and winter season, but I think we made huge strides. No matter what we place tonight, everybody should be proud of what we accomplished this year. It's not just about placements and getting into finals, but about the growth of the program and making things better for future seasons.
How do you have so much storage on your phone?
I did. It was very hard, and it was hard on everybody, including myself. But it was worth it. It was all we could do.
Let's go!
I would say that the successes that you are set up to achieve this year were as a result of the successes you created for yourself last year.
Always remember that if you ever have a chance to go back into the arts at any point in your life, do it, because it'll be a way for you to just kind of wind down. And you know, if it's just a hobby or something that you enjoy on the side of what you normally do in life, then it'll bring you back to all those memories that you had back when you were in high school.
Just cherish the moments, right? The scores matter, but at the end of the day, it's all about what you put into it.
I would say just keep doing you. Keep talking to each other. Keep staying in touch with those that have graduated and reach out to those that are coming in and just keep it going.
I hope you guys did well this past season. To the seniors that graduated, I hope you enjoyed your last year at Granada, that it was a memorable one, and that whatever you guys are up to currently, hope that is going well as well. I will always be here as for outreach if you need help with anything, whether it's music related or not music related, anything.
Well, number one thing, work hard every single time, even if it's just practice. Always give your very best. The first thing is, you never know who's watching, and you never know what might come of each opportunity you get. So treat every performance, every practice, the very best that you can. Well, it was a great run. I appreciate you guys dealing with me. I know I was very hardcore at times, but it's because we want the best, and I know we can be the best. I believe in Granada. I believe in all the things that we have in our plan. And great job to everyone.
So I think you should just take away everything you've learned through marching band. And obviously it's not like, you know, your triplets on like percussion or anything like that, right? Don't take that at college. But take everything you learn in terms of time management. That's always the biggest one. I mean, I've done drum corps, winter guard, all this stuff. And it's not like I'm spending flag in college now, right? It's just all the time management, all the skill, the leadership skills that you learn. It just translates super easily into, you know, the real world, right? And obviously, if you do decide to go on and doing indoor, outdoor, like drum corps and all that stuff, then just everything you learn here, you have to just up it up a bit, and then you'll do great.
Ooh, graduating seniors. Keep going. If you love music, keep going, and don't ever count yourself out, right? Because some players really flourish actually in college, or not even in college. It might be when they get out of college and they face the real world, and then they get more serious about, you know, what am I really about as far as a musician, right? So if you do want to do music, which I hope a lot of people do, you have to be willing to take a job that's not in music in order to pay your bills until you're ready to, until you're at the level where you're going to make money at music. And if you can, choose a job that's not going to suck all your energy out so that you have time outside of the job to pursue your music, right? And just, it's like a very personal spiritual journey, music, you know? Like really, if anyone wants to take it seriously, then just make it something that's part of you, regardless of what job you have or anything. And then if you work hard at it, hopefully you will get them to merge together where you're actually able to work within the field that you're passionate about, you know?
It was very awesome meeting all of you, and not just because it's my first school, and I won't forget my first school, but these kids, these students, they're unforgettable, these players. I learned a lot about myself and how I teach. I learned a lot about high school marching band, and I'll take that with me for the rest of my life. So thank you to the students who are moving on from high school, and I hope you all have wonderful lives and that you can take something from your time here in the Granada Charter Marching Band and, you know, let it give you love.
Thank you.
It's always bittersweet, but that's the nature of it. So you're only here for a short time, so you make the most of it. It's exciting. Oh, I thought they said my name for a second. It's exciting. I don't know, I've seen some of you guys since you were in middle school, and it's like, I don't know, it's kind of surreal, because I feel like I haven't been doing it for a long time, but I really have. So, I don't know, it's also existential. some questions to ask myself, but I'm really proud of this class, and I feel like it's the first one that I've really left, like, a strong mark on. Not that I feel like I don't leave strong marks on students, but, like, I feel like it's the first one that I can really say are, like, my kids, you know. Yeah.
Nice. Thank you.